Should you learn C++ in 2020? I'm gonna answer this, so hang on with me till the end. How is it going, everyone? Welcome to my channel. I am Daksh and I am here to talk about should you learn C++ in 2020? And the answer is there is no universal answer, and that's the precise reason I will talk about three specific type of people, and then we will talk about whether they should learn C++ or not. So first and foremost, we are going to talk about students who are learning computer science. Second, we are going to talk about people who know other programming languages but not C++. And third, we will talk about people who are not working on C++ now, but they may have worked on C++ in the past. So let's start and talk about students first. Now, as a student of computer science, should you learn C++? The answer is yes, yes, and yes. Being a student means you are learning, and C++ is a must for you. Let me first talk about a secondary benefit. With C++, you will learn C also. So, two languages in the effort of one. But let me talk about primary benefit now. When you learn C++, you build your foundations of programming, learning programming. C++ is just like genie in a bottle. You know, you can make use of it for something good, or you can screw up whole lot of things. And when you do that, you learn more. Learn C++, code data structure, allocate and deallocate memory, write big programs, and learn programming. Okay, this is the building block, the foundation of your learning into programming world. So most of the time, students are being discouraged from learning C++ because you know what? The obvious reason is you will have to handle memory. There is no garbage collector. But let me clear a serious misconception over here. Even if you are using a language with Python, Java, JavaScript with garbage collector, you still face memory issues. Because garbage collector is not an artificially intelligent entity, you need to tell it to be able to work, okay? And if you learn C++, you are a better programmer and you are better equipped to tell when to do so. And over the past 20 plus years of my experience, I have seen that a good C++ programmer ends up writing better code in Python, Java, JavaScript, Go altogether, okay? So build your foundation, learn C++, learn data structure, learn how memory is being handled. As a student, this is what you must do. Now, let's talk about people who are currently either working on or know different programming languages like Python, JavaScript, Java, Go, Scala, etc., but not C++. Now, here is the point for you. If you are good enough in the language you are working and have a decent job profile or work profile with that language, you do not need to learn C++. It will be highly beneficial for you to, you know, being part of the ecosystem for that particular language and make sure that you increase your expertise, you increase your community contribution, you increase your involvement in that ecosystem. That is going to pay you in longer term, and hence you do not need to learn C++. However, if you are scouting for learning new language because of, you know, you are not liking your language or you want to look for better job prospects, then you must consider C++, and I will tell you why. The biggest reason is job prospects. You know, most of the companies around the world are having requirement for C++ engineer, and most of them are not able to find good C++ engineers. So if you are choosing C++ as a career prospects, there is less competition over there as compared to languages like Python or JavaScript. For example, if you are learning Python, you will be competing with 10-year-old to 60 plus years of old, along with lots of freelancers. So basically, they are extremely crowded places, okay? And if you want to excel and make a name of yourself, it is relatively very difficult to do that. But with C++, it's becoming a kind of niche. But it is here, it is gonna be here for a very long time. So it's important for you to give C++ a consideration. Now, beware, learning C++ is a bit difficult, especially if you haven't learned it earlier. And you know what, you need to unlearn lots of things before you can actually learn C++. And it is not going to be 1 to 2 tutorial kind of thing. If you are working full time, you may need to end up spending 1 to 2 months, part time 3 to 6 months before you can actually say that you have learned C++ and understood C++. Okay. Of course, there are people who can learn it faster, but it will definitely take more time than any other languages which you have learned in recent past. So if you are up for it, you can consider C++. And also, again, just like students, your programming foundation will be high, will be good if you learn C++. Now let's talk about people who are currently working on different languages but had worked on C++ in the past, maybe 5 to 10 years earlier or even earlier than that. Now to all of you, if you haven't moved on, remember, if you haven't moved on, then there is no harm in taking a look at your ex, because your ex is today totally different from what it was when you left your ex. Okay, here ex is C++. So C++ today is totally different than what it was 10 years back. If you haven't worked on C++ 11 onwards, it's a totally different programming language. Nobody now writes new or delete. Okay, it's a metaprogramming language. It has transformed itself to a metaprogramming language, and the standardization committee has come up with a schedule that every 6 years a major release, 3 years minor release. 11 was major, 17 was major, 23 is gonna be major, 14 was minor, 20 the current specification is minor. So I sincerely believe that being an ex-C++ programmer, you must actually know what C++ 20 has to offer, so that tomorrow when you are gonna make a decision, you can take an informed decision, because C++ is going to be here for a long time. It will remain in a niche, but it is not going to be replaced as people are expecting it to be. Okay, it is going to be here and remain here for a long time. Now, the good thing for you will be that, you know, since you have learned C++ earlier, it will be relatively easy for you to understand C++ today. And you can also, you know, appreciate the fact that how much the language has changed. So that's the reason I'm calling on all ex-C++ programmer to take a look at C++ 20 before taking any decision on doing something in any other language. Okay. Of course, there are some cases where C++ might not be suitable, but still there are lots of places, lots of cases where C++ is still suitable a lot. Okay, many of the front-end things which we are using has C++, JavaScript engine, MongoDB, they all were built on top of C++. C++ is a major component of all these systems. Okay, so that was my answer for should you learn C++ in 2020. If you like my content, please, please, please take a moment to like, comment, share and subscribe. Thanks a lot, people. Thanks for watching. Till the next time we meet. Good day, goodbye. Take care.